Hey friends, it's Tawney Seren here with Peep Show Toys, and today I want to talk about a strange topic that I think really will end up applying to all of us at some point in our lives, grief and masturbation. So let me kind of go into some more details about what I'm talking about here. So for instance, recently my grandmother passed and it was going through a really hard time. I wasn't looking for sex. I didn't really want to pamper myself or take care of myself. I kind of just felt very isolated and very, you know, down for a while. And grief and death can hit us at anywhere from a young age to a very old age. It will in many places in between, and is something that we sometimes have a hard time dealing with, and it can absolutely cut us off from sex with our partner, playing with ourselves, and self-love in general. So I ended up making myself sit down and have time with myself and explore myself and turn myself on, despite not feeling much like it, because quite frankly, I wanted the endorphin release. I wanted to be able to sleep better. I wanted to just kind of relax, and I wanted to spend time with myself. And it can be very, very difficult to want to do that with yourself as well as with your partner when you're in a stage of deep sadness, grief, depression, things of that nature. Let me tell you one extreme versus the other here in a sense, because there's many different ways that masturbation and grief can go hand in hand. So for me, it was an aversion to sex and masturbation. So I was sad. I didn't want it. I didn't feel like my body could get turned on. I wasn't in the right head space, despite whether or not maybe my body was. And that was something that I found before I could just have sex with my partner and get in the mood. I had to kind of play with myself and have to have my own kind of alone time while I was working through that sadness, because I was afraid that I was going to start having sex and then want to back out because my head wouldn't get in the game and things like that. So it's important to kind of get in a relaxed place where you don't feel like you're letting anyone down or stopping things once they're in motion. The only person that you're turning down is yourself, and you're okay with that. Being alone with yourself and kind of doing that can create a comfortable situation where you are able to masturbate. And it can help with sleeping if you're having a hard time because you're upset. It certainly helps with releasing some of those happy endorphins. It's a great way to connect with your body even when your mind is absolutely all over the place or feeling extra down, a way to kind of boost yourself and give yourself some self-love. Masturbation is very, very important for that. So on the other end of the spectrum, a lot of people also may find that they really crave sex and masturbation after grief or something traumatic has happened. Sex and masturbation provide an escape a lot of times from these thoughts and the sadness that you might feel. It's a way to kind of redirect that and really focus on that positive interaction with yourself or your partner, and you know, the excitement, the endorphins, the, you know, that jazzy fun that kind of like erupts in your body after you've had a really good sexual experience can be incredibly addicting, especially when you're in a place where you're not feeling like yourself, or you're not feeling happy, or like you're feeling you can't access that pleasure while you're in that mindset. So overall, I would say that the most important thing to understand is that feeling the need to masturbate or working to have yourself masturbate when you're in a stage of grief and sadness is perfectly okay. This is fine. Having something like a death or a traumatic event happen does not mean that the pleasure from your own life must be stripped. Having that self-love and taking that time to worship your body or reconnect with your body or even use it as just a temporary escape for yourself is okay. And if it gets to the point where it's obsessive and you're pushing everyone away and all you want to do is masturbate, that's a different story. But using it temporarily as a form of self-therapy is something that is really, it's fine. It's absolutely fine to do. So whether you are sad or happy, masturbation is healthy. It's wonderful, and it's something that you can certainly use to heal yourself as well. So thank you so much for letting me yap. I'm Tawney here with Peep Show Toys, and I will certainly be back with more education, so don't forget to subscribe. Goodbye!